The first step is something like Apollo, in which people bring their own habitats, the spaceship itself and spacesuits. Second step is extended artificial environments, a domed room or house or village. But the third step, which does seem to be accessible, that is, it's consistent with physics and chemistry, is to actually transform the environment of a planet like Mars so you could live there without taking heroic technological measures. Sometimes that's called terraforming, mm-hmm. transforming another environment so it is like Earth. And that also looks doable for Mars, for Venus with its 90 atmospheres pressure and 900 Fahrenheit. We speak centigrade in Canada, right? Mm-hmm. What is it, 470, something like that, centigrade. In surface temperature, that's a much tougher nut to crack. But Mars not. And as I say, all of this seems very blue sky, very science fiction-y. What are we talking about? But that's because we think of it in terms of doing it today. And of course, we can't do it today. It's too expensive and it's too difficult. But as time goes on, the urgency will become clearer. The technology will become more available. The enterprise will be increasingly less expensive. And there's a time when the curves will cross, and it will be cost-effective.
Do you think, really, we should be spending money, time, and energy in figuring out how to get off the planet rather than trying to fix the planet and undo the damage we've done?
You see, that question is an either-or question. And it falls into the category of fallacy called the excluded middle. Mm-hmm. Why only one or the other? Why not both? Why not an investment in both short-term and long-term? Why not do something that gives a hopeful vision of the future to young people, who many of whom have lost any sense of truly exciting futures, benign futures? This would be a case where nations would be working together for a common future. And there are not many cases of that where things are working today. Also, why is it fixing things here, including the environment, versus space? Why not fixing things here, including the environment, versus the military? When the military in the United States, including hidden costs, spends well over 300 American billion mm-hmm. of dollars a year, whereas the NASA program is a paltry $14 billion a year. I don't mean this critically to you, but many people say, mm-hmm. Space is all these other things we should be doing. But the military in a post-Cold War era, when there is no strategic threat from any superpower, it's very strange that we don't ask that question in the context of defense budgets.
Thank you very much for this, Dr. Sagan.